I might have your attention, please? We're ready to start. So good evening, happy Wednesday. Welcome to McLaughlin Middle School for the 2019 McLaughlin's Got Talent Show. My name is Dave Elliott, Mr. Elliott. My co-director is John Banks, Mr. Banks. Tonight's sponsor is the McLaughlin School Parent-Teacher Organization. Thank you. Thanks for joining us. We've got a wonderful show for you tonight. Could we have a round of applause to get this show started? See some excitement. So tonight, as we approach the final 2 weeks of school, we'll find out who will walk home with MGT's coveted 2019 title. Thank you. And winner of best talent in our school. Last year we had 20 acts trying out. This year we had 34. It has been an exciting time from sign-ups to 2 days of auditions, to rehearsals, to tonight's finale. We have an amazing lineup of talent. For those of you that were here last year and thought it was good, this has gone up another step. Trust me. So let's get started. A trivial note. The order of tonight's contestants was done by lottery in order to provide fairness to all. Our first contestant is a straight-A student who plays soccer and softball. She loves school, especially math. She has her sights set on attending Yale University and becoming a family doctor. Her favorite quote is from Spider-Man, "With great power comes great responsibility." Back for her second straight year, for MGT, performing Cups by Anna Kendrick, please welcome Kaden Warren. next contestant is a sixth grader who performed one of the leading roles in our recent drama production entitled Register Here. She is another straight A student. She loves to sing and write stories and poems. Her favorite hobby is collecting rocks and minerals. She is inspired by Ed Sheeran and will be singing one of his songs tonight entitled I See Fire. She is here with her dad, Jed Ayers, who will be playing backup on the guitar. Put your hands together for sixth grader Kaylee Ayers.
Watching over your sons.
welcome two eighth graders. Technical difficulties up here. So while we're waiting for this, I wanted to ask how many people out here are America's Got Talent fans. Do we have anybody out here that watches that? Did any of you see last night's Golden Buzzer by Howie Mandel? If you have not seen it, Google it, pull it up. It is one of the most heartfelt moments I have ever seen on the show. We played it today in front of my class. Some of my class members were in tears watching it. It was very, very powerful. We're a little bit of a spin-off of America's Got Talent, trying to do some things like they do. Of course, we don't have all the technology, but we're trying. All right, next we welcome two eighth graders who are both members of the McLaughlin Orchestra. Zayamara hopes to one day be a wildlife biologist. She is a member of our Green Club, enjoys reading and drawing, and is a violinist. Daly plays the cello, has been on principal's list for 2 years, and she wants to be a biologist. She plays field hockey as well. Daly's favorite quote reads like this: "Beauty is not what's on the outside, but what makes us on the inside." Sharing this thought through their music and performing Alleluia by Leonard Cohen are Zayamara Rivera and Daly Maxim. Our next act is a sixth grade student who is a pancake, taco, and buffalo chicken connoisseur. She hopes to one day be a dance teacher, band teacher, or hairstylist. Performing Patriotic by Steve Barnett on her trumpet is Ali Bureau. Next act pairs two singers who are high honor roll students. Maya participates in lacrosse, cross country, and track, and hopes to one day be a surgeon. Her favorite quote reminds us all of how we should be as humans. If you don't know a good person, be one, so you can be the good in the world. Maya's partner, Samantha, plays softball and volleyball. She hopes to make a career out of singing or acting or be a teacher. Sam's inspiration is our very, inspiration is our very own chorus teacher, Mrs. Grant. Performing Fight Song by Rachel Platten, Amaya Bright, and Samantha McIntyre.
Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion. Like I was saying, a word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. And all those things I didn't say, wrecking balls inside my brain, I will scream and blow tonight. Can you hear me? Turn on, start right now, oh. like a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Prove I'm alright song. My powers turn on. Start right now, I'll be strong. I play my fight song. Now I care of nobody else.
Performing next is an all-around individual. Who is a cheerleader and best buddy. She is deeply involved with her church youth group. Her true inspiration is her mom. I know she's in the audience tonight. She hopes to one day own a dance studio and make a difference in other people's lives. Her contemporary dance act will have you twisting in your seat. Performing to the song Ocean Eyes by Billie Eilish is eighth grader Tatiana Vance Ralston. A champion is not defined by their wins, but how they recover when they fall. This favorite quote was chosen by and defines our next contestant. She is a high honor roll and principal's list student. She played one of our leading roles in her character with McLaughlin's recent drama production. Along with acting, she loves to sing and cook. Her parents are her inspiration because they always make time for her and her brother. She hopes one day to own her own restaurant. Performing Stand in the Light by Jordan Smith is our very own Kara Harrison. And kindness, hold on to your faith. You get what you give, and it's never too late to reach for the branch, climbing high, leaving sadness behind you. Fight hard for love. We can never give enough. And this is who I am. Our next act is a baton-twirling duo. Both participated on the award-winning McLaughlin Majorettes. Haley is following in the footsteps of her mom, who was also a majorette. Gabrielle aspires to one day be a veterinarian to help sick and injured animals. The duo will be performing to the hit song Come Alive by The Greatest Showman. Please welcome Haley Bingham and Gabrielle Bobin. Making a return to the stage for a second consecutive year, our next act is Shooting for the Stars in hopes to one day be an astronomer. He has played soccer for the past 4 years and enjoys video games. He's a straight A student, loves pancakes, and his favorite quote is, "Your deeds are your monuments." He will be playing the song Halo by Beyoncé on his saxophone. Give a warm round of applause to Merritt Lessier. fair to all the contestants. Their favorite quotes are love the life you live the life you love. And the greatest glory in living lies not in never failing, but rising every time we fall. The strength in these quotes symbolizes what these two individuals represent. Nisa is on high honor roll, and Alicia has perfect attendance. A rarity these days. Nisa loves field hockey, theater, and drawing. Alicia enjoys cooking, field hockey, and is a majorette. Performing McLaughlin Comedy Live, give it up for comics Nisa Barrett and Alicia McCoy. From Our next act features an eighth grade student who has been dancing for 10 years. She also played softball for 5 years. She is a well-rounded individual as shown by her love for her other hobbies, including archery, swimming, and songwriting. An honor student whose favorite food is tacos, she will be singing Take Me to Church by Andrew Hozier. Please put your hands together for Alexis Pelletier.
Take me to
our next contestant earned a Presidential Gold Award and a $5,000 scholarship for academic excellence. She leads by example as a cheerleader, a member of Cougar Congress, and an eighth grade president. Her favorite food? Chocolate chip waffles. Her inspiration comes from two of her own classmates who have dealt with cruelty in the world around them and still have smiles on their faces every day in school here. Singing This Is Home by Cave Town, please welcome Madison Houle.
I can't fall.
Okay, following our next act, we'll be taking a 10-minute intermission. Our PTO will be offering baked goods, pizza, and drinks in the rear of the cafeteria. So be sure to get up, stretch, and help support your parent-teacher organization. Okay, this next act is pretty cool. These three dancers hail from a country some 7,000 miles from Manchester. Abedi is representing, along with his brother, which they've just added into tonight. So Abedi Lubanga and Martin Lubanga and Amani, they are representing the nearly 200 ELL students here at McLaughlin. They play soccer, they enjoy reading, and I have two of the three in my class, and I can tell you every day I am the student. They are the teachers. They speak very little English, and it is very challenging, but it's certainly been fun. Hailing from Tanzania and performing the song Anything by Peace Square, please welcome Martin and Abedi Lubanga and Amani Martini. Okay, we're going to pick the pace up here. It is time to introduce our judges. Brittany Labonte works for the Office of Youth Services in Manchester. She works closely with the police and fire departments and school administration. She has been with OYS for 4 years now. She is a graduate of Granite State College with a master's degree in leadership. She is currently attending Plymouth State University for her second master's in clinical health and licensed alcohol and drug counseling. Brittany meets with the students that attend this school who are at risk and provides a multitude of resources to them and their families. Please welcome Brittany Labonte. Detective Shannon Jackson is our school resource officer. She has been a police officer for 15 years before coming to Manchester PD. Before coming to Manchester PD, she served on the New York City Police Department. She has been in the juvenile division for 5 years as a school resource officer, with this being her second year at McLaughlin. She is a mother of 3 children, ages 9, 7, and 7. She earned a full track and field scholarship to UMass Amherst. Please welcome Detective Shannon Jackson. This next judge attended Hillside Middle School. He's a 1980 graduate of Manchester Central High School. And it's not the one that you see on the screen. We're a little out of order. There he is. He previously taught math and served as an assistant coach on several boys' state championship basketball teams at Central High School. He is currently finishing his 20th year here at McLaughlin. He served as assistant principal for a number of years and has been principal here for approximately 8 years, I believe. Please welcome that guy on the right up there, Mr. William Krantz. So I texted his wife today to get that beautiful picture on the right. Wasn't he a handsome looking guy? All right. Our next judge is a Manchester native and has been a dancer and performer for 23 years. For the past 5 years, she was a member of the Boston Celtics dance team and was a dance team captain for the past 2 seasons. Lindsay was also a member of the UNH dance company for 4 years in college. She has performed all over the country and overseas as well. She's performed in Italy, Spain, Las Vegas, New York City, Myrtle Beach, Orlando, New Jersey, and of course, Boston. Some of Lindsay's other accomplishments include previously holding the title of National Miss Dance USA, being featured in Dance Spirit magazine, and most importantly, sharing her love for dance through teaching dance to aspiring dancers. She is thrilled to be here today as a McLaughlin Middle School alumnus. Please say hello to Lindsay Pelletier. Born and raised in Manchester, our next judge is Mayor Joyce Craig. She grew up in Ward 8, is a graduate of Manchester Public Schools, having attended Green Acres, Southside, and Memorial High School. After she earned her degree in business administration from the University of New Hampshire, Joyce worked as a marketing director for 15 years where she developed strategic plans and managed multi-million dollar budgets. Joyce began her public service in 2007 when she ran for and won a seat on the Board of School Committee. In 2009, Joyce served, won a seat on the Board of Mayor and Aldermen and served 3 terms representing Ward 1. On November 7, 2017, Joyce became the first woman to be elected Mayor of Manchester and was sworn in. She was sworn in as the city's 48th mayor on January 2, 2018. She and her husband, attorney Michael Craig, have 3 children, William, Sarah, and Catherine. Joyce is also an avid runner, and she has completed 14 marathons, including 10 consecutive Boston marathons. Please welcome our mayor, Joyce Craig. thank you all for being here today. We really appreciate it. All right, kicking off the second half of the show is one of our longest serving faculty members. He is nearing completion of his 20th year as a physical education teacher. And get this, he is a graduate of Archie Bunker Middle School, George Jefferson High in the Bronx, New York, and Riverdale University with a Bachelor of Science. Representing the McLaughlin School faculty, playing piano and singing Choppin' Broccoli by Dana Carvey, please give a rousing applause to our very own Mr. Stephen LaCasse.
Okay, but I'm glad to be here, and I think it would be a fair statement to say that every comedian here would prefer to be a rock star in real life, because I think rock stars are the coolest people on the planet. Rock stars are very hip, always flare their nostrils, look like they're about to vomit. They always have that preamble before the song that makes no sense at all. You know, ladies and gentlemen, a long time ago, there were lots of people. That's all I'm trying to say. And a lot of these lyrics, you gotta admit, when you hear songs on the radio, some of these lyrics are very generic, very trite. I mean, to me, it sounds like the guy is making them up as he goes along. You know what I mean? It's like, she's cold as ice. Paradise. And the feeling was nice. There's a lady I know. If I didn't know her, she'd be the lady I didn't know. And my lady, she went downtown. She bought some broccoli. She brought it home. She's chopping broccoli. Chopping broccoli. She's chopping broccoli. She's chopping broccoli. She's chopping broccoli. She's chopping broccoli. She chop, she chop, she chop.
Thank you.
Mr. LaCaste never knew what was going on behind him. Never knew. And still doesn't. Okay. Our next act is an eighth grade duo playing drums and guitar. Both Josh and Nate are on principal's lists. Josh was one of three band members recently selected for Honors Band and just last week won the Firefighters Challenge here at McLaughlin School. He plans on being a video game designer. Nate is a boys basketball champion and a captain for both his football and basketball teams. He dreams of being an athletic trainer, performing a combination of five songs. Please welcome The Lightning, featuring Josh McDonald and Nate Davis. Thank you. Our next contestant is on principal's list and is the Cougar Congress secretary. She plays basketball, is on the cross country and track teams for McLaughlin. She is also a Seacoast United Academy soccer player. She claims her parents are amazing role models and are her rocks. Her favorite quote is quite telling, and it goes like this. It's going to be hard, but hard doesn't mean impossible. Singing a song she wrote entitled, You're With Me. Put your hands together for Emma Rossi.
Looking out on these
next act features a trio of eighth graders. Emma is on President's List and a member of the National Honor Society. She hopes to be an actress or a lawyer. Sebastian dreams of being an interior designer and was recently selected for district festival. Leah is on principal's list and is hoping to become a journalist. Sebastian and Leah were both recently selected for chorus district festival. The name of their group is SEL3. They will be doing 80s medley. Please welcome Emma Burns, Sebastian Barr, and Leah Dolan. This next act features a singer who is on principal's list and who was recently chosen to represent McLaughlin's band at District Fest. She plays soccer and cooks in her spare time. She loves ice cream. She credits her sister Bree and her mother Shannon as the strongest and most beautiful people she knows. Singing Sunflower by Shannon Purser, here is Rebecca Ducre.
Thank you.
Our next act showcases our first magician in 2 years. He yearns to one day be a lawyer. His favorite hobbies are ones that make him think, including reading and puzzles. No wonder he will share his card trick skills with all of us here tonight. Remember Shin Lim, who was crowned champion on season 13 with America's Got Talent? This next contestant idolizes Lim and shows shades of the great one. Here is McLaughlin's own, Lucas Miller.
Two of them. The first trick, I'm going to pick someone to help me out with this trick. So, two helper cards, don't we? King and Jack. So these will be my two helper cards for this trick. What I'd like you to do is I'd like you to take the deck face down, and I'd like you to sort the cards in two different piles. The king will be the red pile, and the jack will be the black pile, okay? And I'll tell you. Actually, just stop for a half a minute. For example, like you put a couple right there, and then another right there. Whichever, if you think one is red, put it in the red pile. If you think one is black, put it in the black pile. We're going to do switch to two piles. So red cards will go on the right, and black cards will go on the left.
Yeah, Luke!
Next are two singers. One, Alexandra, wants a career as a doctor. The other, Alyssa, is a future vet. Both competed on the track team. Alex likes pizza, and Alyssa likes mac and cheese. Both earned top grades in school, and both are inspired by our very own Mrs. Grant, their chorus teacher. Singing John Legend's All of Me are Alexandra Wolgamott and Alyssa McCarthy.
Without your smile, drawing me in and you kicking me out.
okay, a talent show isn't one without a beatbox battle. These two individuals showcase a competitive spirit, off the stage as much as on. Pedro is back to make another statement. He states that his academic achievement is learning English when Spanish is his first language. He plays soccer and basketball and can often be found in the boxing ring at MPEL. His rival this year is Henry. And Henry has never failed a karate test and one day hopes to walk the beat as a police officer. Tonight's beatbox battle features newcomer Henry Hun and veteran Pedro Colon Rivera.
Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen.
two left. Our next act is a sixth grade saxophone player who aspires to one day be an artist or a lawyer. A straight A student, she plays field hockey and basketball. She loves art and beef and spinach burritos. Playing Defying Gravity by Wicked, please welcome Grace McDonald. Okay, last but not least is another Principal's List recipient. She loves singing and cooking and dreams of a career in the dance field. She shares her favorite quote with you tonight. The only person you can compare yourself to is the one you used to be. That parallels her friends and family who inspire her because they push her to be a better version of herself every day. Dancing to the song Human by Christina Perry, here is Olivia Pike. Okay, we would like all of our contestants to please come up on stage. You can go out the side, come in from behind the curtain. We will recess just for a few moments while we tally the judges' votes, so we'll be right back. I may have your attention. All right, so we have a couple of people we'd really like to thank. We had two people working with us today. One was our curtain puller over here, and the other worked as a stagehand. So Max Regis, step out, Max, come on out. Paul Bouvier helped us with our stage up here today, so thank you very much, guys, both of you. We appreciate it. And you can stay right there. Max, I know you got to pull the curtain here in a minute. All right. So prior to announcing our winners, we want to have all of our contestants take one final bow. A lot of hours went into preparing for this talent show. And we wanted to say thank you to all of our contestants. So could you open the curtain there, Max, please?